Someone is in my computer controlling it. What do I do? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's a question I got, and it's a question that I get fairly frequently. My computer is being controlled and I cannot load anything I've purchased. Seems like when I change my password, it asks several times, not good. Also, when I do, it is intercepted and blocked. Why? This is my personal home computer. As I said, I get variations on this kind of question. Fairly often, somebody believes that their computer is being monitored, being played with, that somebody has access to it. They're convinced that someone is spying on them, or worse. Now, before I go on, I want to basically acknowledge two things. If this is honestly, really happening to you, I can't help you. This is a situation where you really need to get in-person, on-premises help from somebody who can take a look at the specifics of your situation, the specifics of your machine, and help you through whatever it is that's going on. The reality, though, is that given the number of people that generally come to me with this kind of suspicion, I'd say 9 times out of 10, there's nobody stalking you. Unfortunately, we tend to fear things we don't understand, and when our computer starts to behave in ways we don't understand, it's really easy to jump to some bad conclusions that maybe you're being spied on, or worse. Now, here's a really frustrating part, at least from my position. Even though 9 times out of 10, nobody is looking at you, nobody is spying on you, nobody is messing with you, I can't prove it. I can't prove that someone is not spying on you. I can't prove a negative. I can't prove that your machine does not have malware. I can't prove that my machine doesn't have malware. If you find traces of malware, you've proven there's malware. But the lack of traces doesn't mean there's a lack of malware. I can't prove to you that someone isn't messing with you, but I can give you some more mundane explanations for some of the things that you may be experiencing that you might be chalking up to being spied on. One of the ones that I love are mouse movements. Your mouse starts moving on its own magically. It's very rare for that to be a malicious activity. But what's much more common, the mouse is dirty, or the surface that you're on is not particularly a mouse-friendly surface, or you've got a trackpad and you don't realize that your finger's getting close enough so that you're actually moving the mouse yourself with, like, your thumb. Another one is typing, where all of a sudden the computer starts typing on its own. As odd as it seems, there are scenarios where that can happen, the most common one being accidentally turning on dictation. That absolutely, it looks like the computer is typing on its own, especially when it's getting things wrong. If you don't realize that it's happening, you're probably not speaking in the way you would want to if you were truly dictating. It's possible that you're typing in the wrong password if you're having troubles logging in. But it can be the sign of a hacked account, which itself is not necessarily a sign of somebody spying on you. 9 times out of 10, it's going to be a typo. But even if it is truly wrong because the account has been hacked, that simply means the account has been hacked. It does not mean that there's something going on with your computer. If you can't log into an online account, that's an online thing, not a computer thing. A lot of people are concerned when they find files that have gone missing. Well, every time I've had this situation where a file has gone missing, it's because I deleted it. I may not have realized at the time that I deleted it, but I deleted it. Similarly, if you can't find a file, you may be looking in the wrong place. I recently covered a scenario where with OneDrive, there could be multiple documents folders on your machine. It's just poor design of the software, which makes it very easy to expect something to be in one place where in fact it lives in another. One of the scenarios that really gets people a lot is in email. Many email programs have the opportunity to filter the view. If you forget that you're looking at a filtered view, then all of a sudden it looks like half your mail's gone. It's still there. It's just being hidden because you asked for a view on your mail, or you accidentally asked for a view on your mail that only causes some of the mail to be displayed. One of the catch-22s here is that if you were actually being spied on, if someone was truly trying to infiltrate your computer and extract your information or break things that are yours, it's much more likely you would see absolutely nothing because they are motivated to hide. It's in their interest to not show that kind of stuff so that they can continue to hide and do what they're doing for a longer period of time. So, what do you do? Well, honestly, it's the same old boring stuff that we've been talking about for years. Use up-to-date security software. Keep your system and all software on it as up-to-date as possible. Use strong passwords everywhere. Don't reuse passwords and use two-factor authentication wherever it's available. Educate yourself to be on the lookout for phishing attempts. Honestly, that's how most malware arrives these days. Of course, back up regularly. It doesn't necessarily prevent anything from happening, but it sure allows you to recover from something if it does. And then finally, secure your hardware. Now, that one's worth a little bit more attention, mostly because if there's going to be a real issue, this is what I have seen as truly honest and malicious access of somebody else's computer. Don't let anyone ever touch your computer if you don't absolutely trust them. If you don't trust your ex-boyfriend or girlfriend to maintain your machine for you, which is what I hear happen, don't let them. A lot of the scenarios that I do hear about that turn out to be honest-to-goodness malicious surveillance turn out to be broken relationships. If you suspect that they've done something, stop using the machine. Instead, secure your computer. And yeah, that's the next step. Do things like understand what it means to keep a system secure. You need to be able to install the operating from scratch. You need to know how to install and configure appropriately the software that you use every day. You need to be able to configure your online accounts for maximum security. You need to know what to look for when you suspect that something is wrong. Now, if you suspect that you are under malicious surveillance, do run full anti-malware scans, up-to-date anti-malware scans on your system. That will detect a lot of the malicious software that's being used for this kind of thing. Do review, well, my article on internet safety because it has a number of steps and ideas and all of the things you need to do to keep yourself safe online. And that's really all this boils down to. I hope this is helpful. I really do. This is one of those situations where, like I said, most of the time it's not a problem, but when it's a problem, it's a big problem. I understand that. For updates, for comments, for related links and more, visit askleo.com/142596. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.